Happy New Year. In the new year, let this next song express our daily desire. Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Will you join me, please, as we sing this one?
So what will this year bring? We don't know. We don't even know what a day will bring forth. So we need his vision, and we need our shepherd, and we need right now to pray. So Father, that is our prayer, that you will be our vision. You said where there is no vision, the people perish. Individually, couples, families, cities and nations and the whole world. We need to be led by your will, and we need to see where we are headed and who we are in Christ. And now, Lord, just for a moment, I want to pray for the family of a young man who died this morning, 32 years old, two little girls. Be there, Lord. Just be there. I know you are. And comfort the loved ones, we pray. Amen. Now, what a perfect way to start a new year. In the Lord's house with the Lord's people, and first day of the year. So we're doing it really well. I like the way we're doing it. Today we start off our feet on the ground. Tomorrow night our board meetings and upward practices start. And Wednesday night, the conclusion to our study of the book of James and quintet. Upward every night this week, Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, but I think Rick has one on Wednesday nights too. But anyway, and we'll complete the week by celebrating Trace's birthday on Saturday. So you couldn't start a year better than this. All right. Kim Seed passed away Friday afternoon after a long battle and many comebacks. When we go off the tube this morning, I want to talk to you about that a little bit. So I'm going to save the last 2 minutes of our short service for that. And Right now, we want to go to our offertory hymn, and it's going to be a cappella. The best I ever heard this was at Branson in the restaurant that has the buffet that we preferred. We're all seated, and just before it was time to get up and go to the buffet, we sang the doxology without accompaniment. And everybody else in the restaurant just stopped what they were doing and either joined us or listened to it. Sandy's going to lead us now. Praise him for all our blessings he has given us. And that was our prayer, and we closed it with amen. Now we receive the offering. So someone may wonder and ask why we just have a 30-minute service, because that's how we do New Year's Day. Whether it comes on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, or whatever day, we have a 30-minute service and we go to the brunch. If we have our service this morning, that's not going to be brunch. It's going to be lunch. So I've got 17 minutes left, allowing time for a hymn at the end, and then those 2 minutes that I want, I've got about 12 minutes. So I don't want to rain on your parade. Everybody's saying, Happy New Year, Happy New Year. New Year, old world. You think turning the calendar reset anything? When that ball dropped in New York, it was just symptomatic of we dropped the ball a long time ago. And we're giving our kids the most dangerous world to live in. I don't feel like saying Happy New Year, except personally. But I said it last year. And we lost Tommy. And we lost Kathy. And we lost others. And Friday afternoon, we lost Mrs. Seed. This year is going to have its low points. We live in a world that hasn't changed one bit. This is the 63rd New Year's Day I've come to this pulpit. All of them were positive and upbeat and rah-rah and exciting and motivating, but this one wasn't too good. 2 years ago, New Year's Day 2021, we'd been called non-essential, and that kind of stung. So the theme that Sunday morning, that New Year's Day morning, was service. We're going to outserve them, outdo them, outwork them, outlive them. And in that year, we stripped this sanctuary and made it new and did so many other good things. And then New Year's Day 2022 came, and we were in trouble as a nation. And the theme last New Year's Day was put on the full armor of God and resist, stand strong. And now we come to this New Year's Day, and we lost. I hope that doesn't offend you. I hope it does offend you. Maybe we'll wake up if it does. But we lost the media. We've lost the academia. We've lost the government to a godless, liberal, leftist movement. That's where we stand now. We have, quote, crossed the line culturally, politically, constitutionally, and morally. So sometimes when something happens, you know then it'll never be the same again. Illegal immigrants pouring into this country by the millions. This country's never going to be the same again. I just don't want to bust your bubble, but we need to face reality. So what are we going to see this year? We're going to see more of the same. More falling away from God. More dropping away from the church. More lawlessness in the streets and even in the courts. We're going to see more dishonesty, and we're seeing so much of it right now in high places. Lies upon lies. We're going to see more sexual insanity. What happened this past year could not have happened 20 years ago. So why did it happen this past year? Because of us. Because our bent on being happy and not being responsible. We're going to see more lust for power, whether it's Russia or China or Washington, D.C. And we're going to see more indoctrination of our children in public schools. That's what we're going to see. Now, close your eyes to it if you want. And live in your bubble if you prefer. But the world you're living in is dangerous. Do you know of any of those things I mentioned that will stop? They'll get worse as this year goes on. Eddie, back in the 60s, I took flying lessons out at the airport. Willie Titus and I. He wanted to do it in order to be flying as a state trooper. And he just talked me into it. And I remember the classes we went to at Carbondale, and then all of the takeoffs and landings that they ran us through. And then the day came for our flight, and they told us how to set the instruments from here to Carbondale, or from here to Memphis. Be sure you're exact, and then you'll get there. But if you're off a little bit, it won't matter right now. But if you're off just a little bit, the farther you go, the more it will matter, you know. Our nation has been off course for a long time. And now we are so far away from where we should be. We don't know if we'll ever get back. And we probably won't. Listen to Titus, 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1 and 2. Now the Spirit, big S, Holy Spirit, expressly unmistakably says that in the latter times, some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits, lies, and doctrines of demons. I'll mention two, MLB and CRT. And having their conscience seared. No conscience. Doesn't bother them to steal elections. It doesn't bother them to besmirch good people. It doesn't bother them to hate like they do. So 2023 will bring us deeper into these last days. Don't kid yourself. Personally, Happy New Year. Let's be happy. But responsibly, we're living in troublesome times. But Christ can make every year a happy year. And one day the ultimate will come. For a Christian, there's no reason to fear any of this. We win when it's over. The church triumphant, not the church non-essential. We'll never forgive them for that. The church is more essential to this world than Congress is. Now, he didn't raise Jesus from the dead for nothing. There is a goal, there is a purpose, and there is an end. He sees what's going on, he knows what's going on, and he's allowing what's going on. And he will have the final word. You want to hear a truly astonishing statement? Revelation 17, 17, if you have your Bible. If not, just mark it down. Revelation 17, 17. For God has put it into their hearts to fulfill his purpose, to be of one mind and give their kingdom to the beasts until the words of God are fulfilled. Globalism is coming fast. The one world government is on the rise because God put it in their hearts to do it. Because that is the trigger to the end of time. So we're on the road again. Same road, but Happy New Year. It's the road to ruin, not the road to redemption and the road to recovery. Oh, we were on the road to recovery, and we could have been. We might yet be, but it doesn't look like this country will ever turn back to God. So they're saying we should pray for our country. How do we pray for our country? I'm going to tell you two ways. Pray that the evildoers will come to a saving faith. It can happen. It did to Saul. Pray that evildoers will come to saving faith. If not, pray that their ability to do evil will be crippled. That's the essence of our praying for this country. That God will save them. That God will cripple them. And that he will come. Listen, please, to John 14. You know it well. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God. Jesus said, believe also in me, the Son of God. God the Son. In my Father's house are many mansions. That word means resting places or eternal abiding places. So in God's heaven and in his plan, there are many such places. I go to prepare one of those places for you. And if I go and prepare one of those places for you, here's what he says, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Do you get that? He wants us to be with him, the perfect Son of God, the sovereign Lord, wants us to be with him. Well, don't turn him down. So, on the road again, let's be on the road to heaven. Because if you're not, you're on the road to hell. There's no other road. They want to say in liberal circles that all roads lead to heaven. That's not right. But I'll tell you what is right. All roads lead to God. And you're going to stand before him. But you're not going to get into heaven if you're a Muslim. You're not going to be saved because you are a Hindu. There's only one way. And Jesus said it. I, Jesus Christ, am the way, the truth, and the life. So we're going to sing two verses of a closing hymn. All the way my Savior leads me. That means all of January and all of February, all of 2023, our Savior will lead us. If that's the case, we're going to come through. Go on your own and you're on your own. But trust the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understanding, and he will direct your path. Let's make a better world for that little baby right there. And her mama. Stand, please, and sing all the way. Seated just for 2 minutes, please. And guys, you can take us off that tube just as soon as you're ready. When we leave here, we're going to go over and get